Hello, my dear students. Today I am going to teach you basics of the matrices. After completing the basics, I will go for the advanced matrices. So, what is a matrix? Definition, types of the matrices. So, our first is the definition of the matrix. An arrangement of number of real or complex but not imaginary. See the definition carefully. It's a collection of the numbers, but how it is? In the form of an arrangement. Numbers should be real and complex but not imaginary. Imaginary numbers we can put it here. Imaginary number means we can't write here minus 1 root or iota. We can't put it. But complex we can put. Say a plus iota b. So that is the definition where we can put only real and complex number, and it is in the form of the arrangement. That arrangement is again in the form of rows and columns. That arrangement is again in the form of rows and columns. Horizontal lines call as the rows, vertical lines we call it as the columns. So then we put it in bracket, we call it as a matrix. So see the definition, so simple. An arrangement of numbers, real and complex but not imaginary, in the form of rows and columns, within bracket, is called a matrix. Elements. The numbers that form the matrix. The numbers that form the matrix, we call those numbers as the elements of the matrix. Matrices are denoted by the capital letters A, B, C, D, capital A, B, C. Elements are denoted by small a, b, c. So as I have given here the example, capital A means this is the matrix. Small a, b, c, d, these are the elements. Then if there are m rows, that is horizontal lines. It means horizontal lines we call them as a rows. And n columns, that's the vertical lines. So it means to the vertical lines we call as the columns. The matrix is of the order m into n or m by n or m by or m into n. If there are m rows, that is horizontal lines, and n columns, that is vertical lines. See this once again. The matrix is of the order m into n or m by n or m cross n. If there are m rows, that is horizontal lines, and n columns, that is vertical lines. Then comes to be the types of the matrices. First is a square matrix. A matrix with equal number of rows and columns is called a square matrix. That is, we have taken the example with 3, 4, 9, 10 rows, 1 and 1, 2. This is the first row and second row. Two rows come to the columns, two columns. So thus there are equal number of rows and columns, as it is a square matrix. And if rows and columns are unequal, we call it as a rectangular matrix. So you can put here square matrix and or rectangular matrix. Square or a rectangular matrix. Square if both are same. Rectangular if unequal. Now column matrix. A matrix with one column. A matrix with one column and any number of rows. is called a column matrix. For example, A, B, C. A, one row, B, second row, C, third row. Because to the horizontal lines, we call the rows. There are three rows. Vertical columns, A, B, C. So thus there is one column. Thus it is a matrix with the rows, three rows and one column. So as the column is one, as the column is a one, so we call it as a column matrix. As the column is one, we call it column matrix. It is of the type 3:1. We write always rows first because there are three rows. So thus it is 3:1. Then see one more example of the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n. Thus we are having 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to n rows. Column is only one. Thus it is 3:1. So it is a column matrix because column is one. Of the type n:1. So a column is one, we call it as column is one, we call it as a column matrix. Now next is a column matrix. A column matrix is a matrix with one column only. Any number of rows are possible. Means column should be one. At any number of rows, that is vertical line is one only, horizontal lines as many as possible. So we call it as a column matrix. So here example I have given with ABC is a matrix with three rows, 1, 2 and 3, and only one column. As the column is one, we call it as a column matrix. As the column is one only, we call it as a column matrix. And it is of the type 3:1. Three rows, we always write rows first. We always write rows first, columns afterward. So three rows we will put first, column is one, we will put afterward. So we call it as a column matrix. And one more example is there, say 1, 2, 3 and any number of elements. So thus we are having like this, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n. So n we have the rows and column is 1. N rows and column 1. So a column is 1, we call it as a column matrix. Consider the matrix 5 only. It's with one row and one column. So it is with one column, so we call it as a column matrix. While writing the column matrix, we won't bother for the rows. Any number of rows are possible. So that's why it is a column matrix. Come to the row matrix. A matrix with one row and any number of columns. Just see rows and columns. So if column is one, it's a column matrix. If row is one, it's a row matrix. So a matrix with one row and any number of columns is called a row matrix. But one row, for example, ABC is a matrix with three columns. 1, 2 and 3 columns. See here, 1, 2, 3 columns. But one row, so it's a row matrix. Now consider 5, 1, 1. It's a matrix with one row. See here, row is one, row column is one. We have no concern with the columns when we are defining the rows. We have to consider only the row. Row is one, so therefore we call it as a row matrix. Next is a null matrix or zero matrix. A matrix in which all entries are zero. a matrix in which all entries are zero, we call it as a null matrix. And it is noted by a thick zero. Make it thick, then it is for the matrix. For example, 0, 0, 0, 0. 2 rows, 2 columns, it means it is of the type 2 by 2. 3 rows, 3 columns with all 0. 3 into 3, thus it is again a null matrix of order 3. Both are equal to, like this put it as, thick 0. It is denoted by thick 0, you can't say it equals. When you will put it as thick 0, it means it is denoted by this thick 0. But it doesn't mean it equals 0. Then, we have a diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix. That is, if all entries other than principal diagonal entries are 0, then we call it a diagonal matrix. Means only diagonal entries are not zero, otherwise all entries are zero. We call it as a diagonal matrix. For example, 3, 4, these are the diagonal elements, other elements are zero. 1, 5, 7, diagonal elements, other elements are zero. We call them as the diagonal matrices. This matrix is of order 2, here it is of order 3. Then a scalar matrix. If in a diagonal matrix all diagonal entries are same, we call it as a scalar matrix. Diagonal entry should be same, scalar matrix. Diagonal entry should be same, scalar matrix. Next is a unit matrix. If in a scalar matrix all diagonal entries are 1, we call it as a unit matrix or identity matrix and is denoted by I, capital I. Here see 1-1 diagonal entries, 1-1 diagonal entries. So as the diagonal entries are 1 and condition is in a scalar matrix. Scalar matrix means in which all entries are same, in which all diagonal entries are same. And then 1-1. Same and 1-1. We call it as a unit matrix or identity matrix. And condition for the unit matrix or the identity matrix is it is always a square matrix. See here I have written 2 into 2. There I have written 3 into 3. That is number of rows and number of columns in both the cases are same. So then we call it as a unit matrix. After that, we have a symmetric matrix. A square matrix is called a symmetric matrix if, by changing rows to columns and columns to rows, the matrix remains the same. If by changing rows to columns and columns to rows, the matrix remains the same. This is what we call transpose also. We are going to do in the next lesson, what's a transpose. When we change rows to columns, we call it as a transpose. So it means if we take the transpose of a matrix that remains the same as the previous one, then we call it as a symmetric matrix. For example, A is 5, 1, 5, 1, 6, 9, 5, 9, 10. We want to change rows to the columns. See here, row is 5, 1, 5. I want to put it as a column, 5, 1, 5. Second row is 169. I will put it as a second column, 169. Third row is 5, 9, 10. I will put it as a third column, 5, 9, 10. So just see, all the entries are same. Therefore, both are equal. So because they are equal, we call it as a symmetric matrix. How to write it? See carefully. Symmetric matrix. Here we have a diagonal and see here the reflection of the two should be same, 1, 1, 5, 5. See once again, here we have a diagonal, Reflection of the two should be same. 1, 1. 5, 5. 9, 9. So then you can call such matrix as a symmetric matrix. Then comes out to be a symmetric matrix. Now next is a symmetric matrix. What is a symmetric matrix? A matrix is called a symmetric matrix if by changing rows to columns and columns to rows, that is by taking transpose, the matrix so form is negative of the given matrix. The matrix so form is negative of the given matrix. Then we call that matrix as an asymmetric matrix. For example, a matrix says 0, minus 2, minus 4, 2, 0, minus 5, 4, 5, and 0. This is the given matrix. Now change rows to columns and columns to rows. 2, 0, minus 2, minus 4. It's a row, make it as first column. 0, minus 2, minus 4. 2, 0, minus 5, second column. 2, 0, minus 5. 4, 5, 0, third row, make it as third column, 4, 5, 0. After transportation, we are taking negative sign common. That I will teach next also, how to take negative sign common from a matrix. We have to take negative sign common from all the entries. I will teach you property also for the timing, you keep it in mind. We are taking negative sign common, so change the sign of all the entries. So taking negative sign common, change the sign of all the entries. 0, this plus 2 to minus 2, this plus 4 to minus 4, this minus 2 to plus 2, this 0 as it is, plus 5 to minus 5, minus 4 to plus 4, minus 5 to plus 5, 0, 0 we couldn't give any, we are not giving any sign to the 0. Anyhow, I will tell you with a minute the story of the 0. So we are getting negative sign common, then this is the same what is given. Therefore, when we change the rows to columns and columns to rows, then our so found matrix is negative of the original one, thus it is a symmetric matrix. So like that we can define the asymmetric matrix. Condition in asymmetric matrix is all diagonal elements are 0. See here, all diagonal elements are 0 in asymmetric matrix. So we'll go next now in the next lecture. Just for 0, I want to tell you one story. See, here we have a number line. You may have done in lower classes 0. Now, when we will start to the left, numbers are positives. They are saying 0 is with us. When we go to negative sign to the left, they are saying 0 is with us. So thus, it is a kind of bridge between two cities, negative and positive. So it's a bridge which connect the negative and the positive. So you will go from the left side, 0 is negative. If you come down from the right side, 0 is a positive. That I will also teach you when I will teach you limit. So like that, positive and negative limit is there, where we are taking 0 as the bridge between the two. So that's all today. We'll continue next. I think next will come out to be still with a few more definitions. 4-5 definitions, just 4-5 definitions are there. I will explain all the definitions there and then I will go with the sums. This chapter is very simple chapter. Be careful. If you are not attentive in this chapter, you won't be able to solve the sums. You have to be very attentive for this. So be attentive. Learn it properly, then you will get it nicely. Thank you. Good night.